for today. Straighten up my room, my head, and my life. Make one person happier. Find a girl whose panic and passion are equal to mine. And I gotta stop making lists of my goals.
Felt the last time? Come on, little guy. Come on. Come on.
He's no dummy. You forgot the foods.
Oh, hey, Sue. Yeah, I guess he always needs a reward.
Well, he's not going to do it for love.
I wonder if he ever would.
He's a rat.
What would you do for love?
Depends on the person.
What if he was a rat?
Andy, you have one problem. Oh. You're never serious enough.
I'm the most serious person you'll ever meet.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, I seriously think that I could love you.
Now, for the past few weeks, you have discovered that the rat, while a primitive form of consciousness, has individual traits. Those traits having been accentuated by the diverse learning experiments each of you has conceived. The next question before us, then, is whether those differences will show microscopically when we examine the neurological structure. Blake, may I use your pencil, please? Now, the fastest and least disruptive way to sacrifice your rat. Oh, and by the way, that is the technical term, sacrifice. Is first to knock it out and then guillotine it. I'll demonstrate with your pencil.
No.
What's that, Reed?
Oh, I said no.
That's what I thought you said.
Well, if it is a sacrifice, why not just one? Stern's rat. He seems to have kind of a suicide complex anyway.
Reed, don't you want to know what's on the inside?
I won't do it.
Well, then I'll do it for you.
Come on, Sash, let's get out of here.
Reed, do you want to lose your scholarship? Come on now, hand it over or I'll have to report you to Dr. Meyerson.
Andy, what difference does it make? That's what the rats are here for. This is the week we kill them. You know the schedule.
Schedule?
Yeah.
Schedule.
What are you yelling at me for? I thought you wanted to love me.
I've changed my mind. Not you.
I'm sorry, but Dr. Meyerson is out of town. He should be back next Wednesday. Well, do you want to leave a message?
Yes. Could you write it down?
Oh, sure.
They're planning to kill rats in the lab this week.
Uh-huh.
And I'm not going to let that happen to my rat.
Uh-huh. Well, what's your name, then?
A. Reed.
Listen, would you take this down to the student union for me?
I'm not going that way.
Well, you are now, huh?
I can't believe it. I'm going crazy.
Well, you're in the wrong class. Just go existential.
Hey, what's that?
It's for George Rakowski.
You got it in the wrong box. Go to the top. Anything else? You want to place an ad?
Maybe.
Okay, but no code ads for fetishes or gun runners. The administration's going to kill the paper if we publish any more of them.
Yeah. Okay. When's the deadline?
Oh, if you get it in by 8 o'clock at night, it'll be in the next day. You can just drop it in the basket in the hall.
Well, so long.
Oh, somebody walked off with my new felt pen.
Well, what do we got here, huh? The girl. The girl. Smart, but not a mathematical genius. Aloof, but able to respond to one person. She'd care a lot about her family. She'd dig simple things, but not go bananas over butter.
Give me that out. It's private.
You can't get a girl with a list. You know what you are? Huh? You're sexually retarded.
That's right, Al. Man, you got me all figured out.
Mm-hmm. You dummy. Look what you did last night. You wrote a list. You're getting weird. You better shape up, kid, and find a goal.
You know, that sounds familiar. I think I heard that somewhere before.
Yeah? Well, Dad's right. You gotta have a goal. So why don't you write that on your little blackboard, huh?
Okay. That's it, Al. That's my goal. Stay sane.
What's going on?
Well, there's a rat in there I have to get for an assignment that's due tomorrow.
Look for yourself.
Thanks. Could you turn the lights on?
You gotta move fast. I got 3 more floors in another building, and I ain't looking for rats here for nobody.
Oh, God, no. They killed them today.
Al, I'm going. Just close the door.
Classified ad number 247. Dig music, dig love, dig life, despite temporary setbacks. If you're female in the same, please answer to A. Reed.
I lost my contact lens.
Forget it. You always find it.
Is this going to take long?
Hey, Reed. Box 55.
Oh, relax. I found it on my collar.
Thanks.
Anytime, eh?
Dear friend, your advertisement, more than a request for companionship, is a cry for help. Therapy may not provide all the answers, but it can open up new possibilities in the life experience. We still have some groups open, so please feel free to call.
Dear Dig Life, so do I. I'm not exactly female, but I am the same. Don't think about it anymore. Do it. We are all one. Frank Schultz.
At two?
I am very female. Dig everything. Tell me your temporary setbacks, A. Reed, and put the answer in the Tommy album at Stereoville between noon and one.
Pick me up by the seat of my pants and put my fingers down on the keys. Sing a story that ends with nobody friends. I'm a sitting on a rock and roll.
Temporary setbacks include, they just killed my rat, Sancho, in a lab experiment. I didn't want that to happen. Other setbacks should be discussed personally. They can be handled if you care. A. Reed.
Ask me for a song to help you along. I'm a sitting on a rock and roll mood. I'd like to help you, but I know it's no good. I'm like a fish that done dropped out of his school. To help you, but he knows at least he thinks he's no good.
I'm sorry about Panza. Is that what you call him, Panza?
Sancho Panza.
Sancho Panza. Nice to talk setback. I mean, I had this hamster once, you know. He used to, all he did was store his food. Like this, you know. I don't know what he was preparing for, maybe the big winter in the sky or something like that. I don't know, but what are you going to do about Panza?
Well, I left a message in the science department, just a personal protest. Another cause down the drain.
Well, what are your other causes?
Well, I don't have any really. I went on peace marches when I was in high school. I worked for Bobby.
And me too.
That whole thing really blew me out.
Wow, tuna fish. Hey, have you ever had tuna fish with peanut butter? I mean, now that's what I call a cause. That's good.
What are your other causes?
Would you believe women's lib? Wow, I really froze on that one, didn't I?
Well, it's just that there's women's lib and then there's, women's lib.
No. Hey, you know what my really, really deep down cause is, though? It's that every moment has to be the highest. It's got to be the uppermost. I mean, well, I had this friend once, a friend, somebody I talked to named Eloise, right? And I sculpted, you know, and I did this piece, and I was crazy about nobody seeing it until she did. And it was a piece of this guy laughing, I mean, really laughing, and this other guy was kicking him, you know? And I showed it to Eloise. I called it Living. And I showed it to her, and she said, "Well, Pam, you really have a tough time facing reality, don't you? I mean, you really think life's a joke. Tight jaw, man. And, I mean, don't you think that life is a joke? Don't you want to laugh your way through life?"
I guess sometimes you just can't laugh. What's wrong?
Well, it's like this. My mother, my father, and my only brother were killed in a car crash a few minutes before 5 on December
1967? My mother died last year.
We both had some pretty big setbacks. It's not just that we both hear the sound of a different drummer. It's that the sadist never takes a break, does he?
You see, it's like concentration. If you concentrate, you can feel the energy between your hands. Feel it? You can also transfer the energy to another person. Here, put your hands up. That's right. Now, lock into my eyes. Can you feel it?
Yeah, I feel like I'm falling into your eyes. It's like a ceremony.
It's an energy transference.
You know, when my parents died, I felt as though my life had stopped too.
Yeah, I know the feeling.
Let me ask you something. Hey, Andy, who's left with your mother dead?
I live in a big house with Bert and Al.
Who are they?
Well, Bert's my father and Al's my brother.
That's somebody.
Well, I don't dislike them. I don't think they like me, though. I kind of drive them crazy.
There are only two of you, just you and your brother?
Yeah, they figured two, boy and a girl. They figured wrong.
Obviously.
My mother liked me anyway.
You know, I love my parents so much that I never stopped to think whether they love me or not. I mean, I really loved them.
And I really love you.
Hey, wait a minute. This you and me thing is going really fast. And I've rushed into a lot of things, and they all were bummers. Is this going to be a bummer?
No. No chance. We're Siamese twins. We're joined at the mouth. Joined at the mouth. The other half of me.
The other half of me.
All my life's a circle.
There you
sunrise
go. Come on over
and
here.
Sundown. The moon rolls through the nighttime till the daybreak comes around. All my life.
Hey, come here.
I still can't find that Croce album. You know how much I love it. It's making me sick and you don't care.
I do care.
I'm hungry. I'll go see what's left after taxes.
Who are you all dressed up for?
Well, I've got an 11:30 Oriental Philosophy, which I'm not going to cut. And I'm not going to go naked. Now sing to me.
Seems like
one quart of pineapple coconut,
before.
Two eggs, which I will brilliantly stretch for the last slice of cheese.
When
could
I?
You're staring at me.
I love to watch your hands break eggs.
You're still staring, and I know what's on your head. Paranoia. So go ahead and ask.
All right. Do you ever think of those other two guys when we're together?
No.
How about when we're apart?
Sometimes.
What? Sometimes.
Very middle class. Me God, how did you ever get an academic scholarship? I mean, those two guys meant absolutely nothing. It didn't work with them. It does work with us.
Why?
Because what you see in me makes me like myself a lot.
Vice versa. I don't know why I get like that.
You're bad. But don't sweat it. I never liked the good guys anyway. I'll get it. Hello?
My brother here.
Al. Yeah.
Andy, come on outside here for a second.
Well.
Come on, Andy, come out here.
Well, what's so private between us all of a sudden now?
Just come outside. I want to get you out of here. Come on. Don't you close any doors on me. I promised Dad I wouldn't touch you, you hear?
What are you gonna do, hit me? I'll hit back, you know.
Andy, just listen to some sense, will you?
Okay, Al. Come on in and tell me some sense.
That's just for you to come home, Andy.
What do you say, Al? Oh, would you like something to drink?
No, I don't. I say come home, too. What the hell are you doing here, anyway?
This is Pam.
Terrific. Listen, you're not going to get any more money from Dad, kid, if you stay here. Not even for college. He wants you home.
Oh.
You're really screwing up your life, Andy. What are you going to do when this is all over, huh?
Well, I didn't figure that it would be over that soon. Kind of a long time thing. What do you think, Pam?
Are you kidding? Without any money?
Well, I'll get a job. I'll go to work. I'll get money, get paid for it and everything.
Oh, yeah, sure. Without any shoes, huh?
Well, there's another thing that I want you to tell Bert. You can tell him that I love her.
Listen, Andy, I've said that to a few girls, too. That's exactly what they want to hear. We're going to go down to the club, okay? And we're going to get in a couple of rounds, and me, you, and Bert, and...
Wait a minute. Would I spoil Bert's game if I didn't go?
Listen, Andy, I got the clubs in the car, huh? Then after that, we'll come back here and we'll get you moved out. You got some neat stuff here, Andy. Chicks like this don't hang around, you know?
Yeah. Could you do me a favor?
Sure, well.
Could you just go over to the door for a minute? Just over to the door.
Okay, I'll go over here and you talk it over with her, okay?
Could you open up the door, Al? Just step on the other side and get out. Get the hell out. Get out, Al.
Okay, I warned you, kid. You're gonna be sorry, Andy. You're gonna be real sorry. You know what you can do with your four wood? Huh? Your four wood, Al?
How about the five iron? The five? The brassy, Al? You know what you can do with your brassy?
Nance can afford to eat anymore.
Hello. Here's to the working class.
Do you need any help?
I do. Hey, how about a little together over at the apple stand?
Do you mind if I take five?
Take five, but please, let's pretend we're working today just for a little bit.
Wow, take a five. I mean, you're going to be learning this jargon and running this place, aren't you?
Mm-hmm. Did I ever tell you that you're the apple of my eye?
Andy! I got a class in a few minutes. I got to run.
I have one at four, so I'll see you in a little while.
Okay. Bye. See ya.
Goodbye.
Every other day.
Of the week is fine.
Yeah!
But whenever Monday comes,
you'll see me crying all of the time. Oh. Monday.
La, la,
it's a sad day. La, Monday.
Do you know that song came out when we were 10 years old? Because that was the first record I ever bought.
You know something?
What?
I hate it when you ride a block and a half behind me. Sometimes I'm afraid that I'm going to turn around and you're not going to be there.
Hey, I'll always be there, you paranoid dummy.
Oh, you sure?
I'm sure.
Yeah?
Sweetheart?
Well, yeah?
Yeah!
Okay. We got some mail.
What did you get?
It's from my father.
Well, open it up. Read it. Oh, I wish I could find that album.
Dear son, enclosed is a picture of yourself that your mother took 3 years ago. That's what you were like, a nice, clean boy. Your mother and I had high hopes for you. Your mother wouldn't like what you're doing. I love you, but you're too young to be doing what you're doing. Remember what I said. A man has to have a goal. He has to make something of himself. Son, I want you to get home. Get home and straighten yourself out like a normal person. I'll give you until tomorrow supper time, and then I wash my hands of you. And I mean it.
Your loving father, Bert Reed.
Hey, what did he say?
Goodbye.
Did he really say goodbye?
Yeah.
Hey, Aunt. Now we both have nobody. I'm glad.
I love you.
Operator.
Yes. Hello, operator. I'd like to make a call to Tahiti. That's French.
One moment. I'll connect you with the overseas operator.
Thank you, operator.
Overseas?
Yes, this party would like to place a call to Tahiti. Go ahead, please.
What number do you wish to call in Tahiti? My album, where'd you find it?
I bought a new one today.
You're crazy, you know that. You're really crazy.
Well, I figured it would get us through finals.
More. My supervisor's on a coffee break.
Is to save every day. Till eternity passes away, just to spend them with you. If I could make days last forever, if words could make wishes come true, I'd save every day like a treasure, and then again I would spend them with you. But there never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do once you find them. I've looked around enough to know that you're the one I want to go through time with.
Now?
Now. Do you like it?
Oh. Well, that's us.
Mm-hmm.
We're immortal.
If I could afford bronze, then we'd be immortal. It only needs one more glaze after it dries.
That's beautiful. Thank you. Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
If I could save time in a bottle, the first thing that I'd like to do is to save every day till eternity passes away, just to spend them with you. If I could make days last forever, if words could make wishes come true, I'd save every day like a treasure, and then again I would spend them with you. But there never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do once you find them. I've looked around enough to know you're the one I want to go through time with.
They say that if two people are together long enough, they start to look like each other. Do you think that we do?
Yeah. Yeah. A little bit around the eyes.
Yeah, I see what you mean.
Hey, wait a minute.
What is it?
I don't know. It's probably nothing.
What's wrong then?
Well, there's just kind of a funny bump. Did you hurt yourself?
No. What is it?
Well, it's just a funny lump.
Yeah, but what kind of funny lump? Are we going to be scared?
We're going to go see a doctor.
Mr. Reed, you can go in now.
Give the lady the basket, please.
Excuse me. Hello. Sit down, sir. What's going on?
Nothing to be alarmed about. We're just going to need some further tests on Miss Rainey. She won't have to stay in the hospital very long.
A hospital?
Oh, now take it easy, son.
What are you talking about?
We're just going to have to wait for the results from the biopsy.
Did you have to have a shot?
A box just for wishes and dreams that had never come true. The box would be empty except for the memory of how they were answered by you.
Andy, look, I am genuinely sorry. With the blood tests and the biopsy, it's pretty conclusive. Why, these things can run on from a few months to a few years. Why, look at you.
Remove it?
No, I'm sorry. That's impossible with this type.
How long for her? Guess. I won't hold you to it. It's a guess.
I would say that she will have to go into the hospital in 8 or 10 months. That time she will have to stay in the hospital.
Let's see. May 15th, she goes into the hospital. She can't die.
I'm sorry, boy, but you'll just have to face up to it.
Face up to what?
There comes a time when we all have to realize that it doesn't go on forever. We're mortal. And so are the people we love.
The tests. Where are the tests? I want to see the tests myself.
At the hospital, we never see the actual tests.
You never saw them? You took somebody's word for it that Pam's dying?
No, I never saw them.
Who did see them?
Probably Dr. Osakawa, one of his assistants.
Dr. Caro, to maternity, please. Dr. Caro.
Excuse me.
Andrew Reed?
Yeah. How'd you know it was me?
Just had a phone call and description. Said I should call out the National Guard. Well, let's get to it. You know where I'll be.
Dr. Shrimp, to emergency, please. Dr.
Oh, Jesus, God.
Hey!
There's the doctor. The doctor's...
Open up, please.
Okay, what's going on? And what's all the screaming about?
Nothing, officer. I just called my doctor.
What is she OD on?
She didn't. She's just a little freaked out, that's all.
On what?
Listen, I don't want to go into it right now, all right?
Maybe I better take a...
Excuse me, but I have a patient in there.
Well, I'd just like to know what's going on.
Then wait here.
Well, I don't have all day.
I can't say I know what you're going through because I don't. If we start the treatment soon, it'll make a difference. So why don't you two try to get it together somehow, huh? Oh, and if she starts in again, this'll keep the cops off your back. Call me tomorrow or anytime. Okay?
Thanks, Dr. Osikawa.
Oh, Andy, we're going to be seeing a lot of each other, and if we're lucky, we might get to be friends. My friends call me Ken.
Okay, Ken. To me. Why are you doing this? Tell me. Tell me why you're doing this. Say something. Say something. Say something.
Can you slap this killing thing out of me? If you can, keep slapping. I want another pill. Now.
Sorry.
What's up? What did he say?
I told him I had a serious disease, and he said, let's talk about it.
Yeah, and did you?
Not much, Andy, baby, not much. I told him we could sit there until the dinosaurs came back, and it wouldn't change a thing. He wants me to adjust to it. Dig it, Andy, baby? I mean, my God, can't you see where we're at? I am dying. I am dying. I'm dying. And you're taking me to a shrink for it? This isn't love story. This isn't some soap opera. This is real.
This is it. Don't say anything. Just listen to me. Put your hands up. Come on, put your hands up. I'll never ask you to do anything else again. You remember, we used to do this. You're not going to die. Concentrate.
Andy, this isn't a game.
You're not going to die.
Why, he's suddenly become God?
Because of what we're going to put into it. I'm going to put more into it than I've ever put into anything else. And so are you. Concentrate. It's like everything else. Pam, people just don't care. They lean back and accept cancer as a death sentence. They don't face it. They're afraid to face it. They're afraid to even say it. We'll face it. Doctors treated people who survived. If we have to tear apart every medical book, we'll find it. You're not gonna die. Say, I'm not gonna die. Say it, I'm not gonna die.
I'm not gonna die.
Say it again.
I'm not gonna die.
Say it again.
I'm not gonna die.
You can cast that in bronze.
Do you think there's really a chance? Really?
We came true, didn't we? You're the only person in my whole life who's alive.
Oh, let me hear you say it again, Andy, please.
I'm not gonna die. I'm not gonna die.
I'm not gonna die. I'm not gonna die. I'm not gonna die.
Let's go to the grill. I'll take you out for your first breakfast.
What's that?
It's the opposite of the Last Supper.
I never studied this hard for school.
Me neither.
It is too bad, Count Dracula, that we cannot get a refund on our scholarship, you know. 3 years' worth is quite a bundle.
Look, if we're in debt for the rest of our lives, it doesn't make any difference if the treatments work.
If.
Just read.
Yes, sir.
We are college dropouts doing a heavy study on death.
Okay.
Okay.
Let me see. You got Hill on new chemotherapeutic agents?
Yeah, I read that.
Okay, how about Dieter and Jackson on treatment of adjacent areas?
Mm-hmm, I read that too. I'm trying to digest the organic juice therapy.
Oh, please, come off it.
No, really. There's a case history in here of a John Gunther and his only son who had cancer and he was on his deathbed, right? And everyone had given up hope. And Gunther turned over to this raw juice and...
Man,
yeah, everything clicked, and the kid got better, and he went back to school, and he was great for a while.
How long's a while?
Look, they're experimenting everywhere, all the time. I know there's someone who's found it. I know it. All we have to do is find that person. And there's probably more than just one person. We just have to find him. And we gotta beat his door down.
Wow, this is the third one I found who had a spontaneous remission after catching hepatitis.
Only as a last resort, huh?
Let's forget heat for now, too.
How hot did they make it?
107.
God!
I also found two more who are working on the Swiss idea. They figure the cancer cells are constantly being made in all of us.
Well, what does that do for me, huh?
Maybe you got some bad programming in your DNA.
Hey, Janis Joplin will be back before they figure out DNA.
Did you call Musterman?
Yeah. He's really onto something big, except he'll never try it on me. He's, you know, one of the good guys, wants to play it safe and win the Nobel Prize in 20 years. Hey, have we discounted hormones?
Paris, le contact n'est pas clair.
Un moment, s'il vous plaît. Je la serai encore.
Uh-huh. Et tu te dis?
Hello. Yes, I'm trying to get in touch with a Dr. Eric Wellman. He's in cancer research.
This is cancer research, and Dr. Wellman cannot come to the phone at this time. Would you like to leave your name?
No, I wouldn't. I've left my name 3 times this week already.
I'm sorry, but Dr. Wellman is a very busy man.
Why didn't you make it person to person?
I've tried that. He's never there. I know this is our man. I know it is. Pam, he's already cured 90% of his skin cancer patients, and that was just Little League. And now he's into immunotherapy on leukemias and Hodgkin's. I've got it.
What?
Swiss Trailblazer is gonna call Wellman.
Let me do my thing, okay?
You operate.
Research clinic.
Hello? This is Zurich, Switzerland. I have a person-to-person call to Dr. Eric Wellman from Dr. Heinz Scheckler.
Yes, one moment, please.
Heinz!
Eric, how are you?
Who is this?
Dr. Wellman, I said my name was Dr. Scheckler because I had to talk to you. Just for a couple of minutes, please. My name is Andy Reed. I know everything that you've done. And I know that you have a cure for cancer. My girlfriend has it.
Well, I'm sorry, but I can't help you. Things are still too experimental. It takes time.
We don't have time.
Well, then I suggest you try Stanford Med Center. They've achieved remarkable local remission through isotopic selective radiation.
We know that. We don't want a treatment. We want a cure.
Look, all I can say is get the best radiation treatment possible and keep your eyes open for a breakthrough.
We have. You've made the breakthrough.
I can't take the risk. I'm still a year or two away, if at all. I really must hang up. I'm due in a meeting in 4 minutes. Good luck.
But what?
Andy, maybe there isn't a cure.
Come on. We have to get to the hospital. That noise, I don't think I could ever get used to that.
Thank you.
No, thank you.
But I have to tell you that this completes the basic radiation series. And you know it's not working.
Well, didn't you mention something about chemical therapy, about injections?
All right. But the one thing you have to understand is I can only try CV-656 on her if there are no ill effects. Now, DNA is tricky. We're tampering with the cell nucleus. The ultimate life particle. And the first sign that we're doing more harm than good, we back off. Dig?
Okay, well, when do we get started?
You two take off and be back in an hour.
Okay, thank you.
Hey, I feel like running.
I know you do. We shouldn't just be bumming around doing nothing. Listen, let's go to the movies.
No!
Well, let's go to the zoo or the planetarium. We can do anything you want to do.
Hey, listen, what's all this jive? Let's go, let's do, let's see. I mean, like everything has to be crammed into a couple hours.
No, I didn't mean that.
Hey, I'm sorry. I know you didn't mean that. Listen, don't I look healthy? Okay, I feel healthy. And maybe I am healthy, Andy.
I mean, never give up, right? Never give up? They'll never catch us, Andy!
Pulse and blood pressure stabilized. Everything else seems normal. It must have had something to do with the CV, or possibly some deeply individualized genetic reaction of hers. Andy, you gotta understand that what we're doing here is experimental. I'm sorry.
For what? She's okay, isn't she?
Yes.
You mean you can't go on with the treatments?
You saw what one shot did.
There's no chance to go on with the treatments?
No, don't give up. I mean, we'll go back to radiation. But don't get caught in the trap of wasting months that you can't ever get back. Do your favorite things, man. Her favorite things.
Our favorite thing is life, Ken.
Hello, do you speak English?
Yes.
Good. I'm calling to find out about a Mrs. Del Lugo. That's right. I have a newspaper clipping from 1970 that says that she was cured of cancer by autoimmunology. Autoimmunology. Right. And I wanted to know if she... Right. Gracias. Goodbye.
She died, didn't she?
In May.
Never liked Argentina anyway.
That only gives us one choice. We're gonna have to get going. Sell some stuff. Pam? 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 Open up! Pam?
Stay away.
Give me that.
No.
It's still San Francisco.
I don't want it.
I won't let you. I want you.
No. You don't want me. You want somebody who is healthy.
We promise that we wouldn't accept that. Your life's all I care about, no matter how long it goes on.
For me, it goes on about 2 more months, baby.
You're alive?
I want to remember what was good. I want it to end now.
Like this?
Yeah. Yeah. Everything's gotten so ugly.
Even one day with you so damn much.
Even one day. There's no future.
Future? What the hell's the future? It's just a lot of nows strung together.
I got something for you.
Feel this new lump under my arm and then say that.
Now give me the razor.
You're the other half of me. You are me. I don't want it either without you. It doesn't mean anything.
Well, want you to live. I want to live in you.
We will. We're going to fight it. We have to fight it.
We only have a little time.
We have a chance. We have a chance now. Wellman, in San Francisco.
Got to be out there somewhere.
This place is incredible. If you were a city, you'd be San Francisco.
What if he isn't home?
Well, we'll camp out front.
Yeah? Wait, hold on for a minute. I'm on the phone. I'll be with you in a minute. Agree with him. What's implied isn't good enough. He ought to know that. Well, I just don't agree. I'll have to start over. Bye. Yes?
My name is Andy Reed.
Andy Reed, I called you on the phone a couple weeks ago.
If this is in reference to treatment, I only take patients by referral. I assume.
I'm dying.
We hitchhiked from L.A.
Sorry. Shouldn't have wasted so much time and energy.
We didn't have time. That's what I told you on the phone.
I didn't talk to you on the phone.
I said I was Dr. Schlechter. Remember?
Ah, yes. Dr. Schlechter. You can come in if you want to. I can't take the case, but you sure as hell deserve a cup of coffee for perseverance.
How'd you come up with Schlechter?
Sharon! We got some coffee? Whoops. Whoops. Almost, Reed.
Excuse me.
Yeah, it's upstairs. Go due south.
Thank you.
Reed, there's something you gotta understand. Her future doesn't depend upon what I'm doing. There's lots of men, excellent ones, who are working on lymphosarcoma itself. Yeah, you see, that's worth 15 points. And with improved treatments, there's a good chance there'll be a cure pretty soon.
We want to take that chance with you.
Well, that's very flattering, but, it's emotional. Reed, I'm a scientist. Science is precise. It takes time. A certain preliminaries, hypotheses.
We can start now.
Do you understand at all what you're asking me? The risks involved.
She's dying.
What about the risk to you?
I can't live without her. And she goes out of the room and I go crazy. I don't want to be without her.
No. What about me, huh?
My risk. There's a banner of my career, my reputation.
Oh, why are you working here 15 hours a day for 15 years? While your wife and daughter are out somewhere? Your daughter, she's next.
Apparently you haven't read my updated bio. There's no wife, no daughter. As of September, I was divorced.
I'm sorry. But it shows you how much you're committed, doesn't it?
You're really pushing me into a corner, aren't you?
Yeah.
Reed, I'll level with you. It might work with her. It might. Or it might kill her. And you too.
You know you can do it. Please, try. Please, you gotta try. Look, see, I have all the tests that they show. Everything that we've gone through here, you see? We went through radiation. It was
right here. Then there was chemotherapy. It worked. Nothing worked. Only chance.
No. You can't let her die. You can't let her die. Please, just try. You have to try. Please.
All right. We'll try it. I have to have informed consent agreements for a complete medical history.
It's all here.
One, two, three, four, five. Just take it easy.
Okay. Are you sure you're not turning me into Frankenstein?
I'm not sure of anything. This is hope that your white blood cells and Pam's lymphosarcoma cells create the right kind of offspring.
What? You mean I'm about to be impregnated?
Aren't you on the pill? Now, next week I'll initiate the first transfer of blood to her, but it's you I'm going to be watching because you've got the livest kind of cells floating around your capillaries. And there's almost as much a chance that you'll wind up with Pam's defenselessness against it as that she'll develop your ability to kill it. It's imperative that you call in every 6 hours.
All my life's a circle, sunrise and sundown. Moon rolls through the nighttime till the daybreak comes around. All my life's a circle, I can't tell you. The years are rolling by.
La, 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 la.
Only $2 in 2 hours. Hey, maybe I better wear a sign, have cancer, we'll die.
No. Oh, you got it wrong, sweetheart.
Have Andy, we'll live.
It takes some more blood from her. The tests have to be wrong.
It's not her blood. It's yours. Can you get in here right away?
No wonder. 103 temperature. You got the flu.
The flu?
Break out the scotch. The 12-year-old bottle.
Yes, sir.
We're frantic because of the flu.
Morning.
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 Sharon told me your fever broke.
That mucus is worth its weight in cobalt.
Right?
Hey, take your paws off my girl.
Is that her?
A little.
Is that?
Yeah.
Damn it. That's what I was afraid of. Glands are enlarging. I'll have to double the doses. It's progressing. We're really fighting time now. You hop downstairs to your bed, okay?
If I went out in the streets right now, I'd be picked up as a junkie. Look at this.
Come on, out of the sun.
Really?
That's right. You're responding.
I always was a good responder. Wasn't I, Andy?
What's up?
Wellman wants me to come to the hospital tomorrow for a biopsy.
Sure has been in there a long time. Positive, isn't it?
It's a remission. Of course, I'm going to have to continue testing. I'm going to keep you two very busy. I'll start making out a schedule.
That means she doesn't have to go into the hospital, and that...
It's a remission, Reed. It's just a remission. But we did that. By God! We did that.
You did it.
What? There has to be a first time.
What now?
Stay in San Francisco and, read the cab. Get a job.
I'll get a job.
And find a permanent place to live.
You know, you'll be seeing a lot of me now.
Yeah.
I'm not.
Yes, you are, just like yesterday.
I'm not cheating.
Would you do me a favor?
I can't play.
No, I want to borrow your chalk.
Don't break it.
I'll never break anything in my life.
What are you writing?
Yeah, what are you writing?
You'll see. Here's your chalk. Remember that.
Hey! She lives! Ha! Hey! She lives! Remember it! It's there for you to see! It's there for you to have! It's there for you to hear! She lives! Hey! Wow! Your ears really sealed that tight? Hey, doctors! Hey, world! Pam lives! She...
If I could save time in a bottle, the first thing that I'd like to do is to save every day till eternity passes away, just to spend them with you. If I could make days last forever, if words could make wishes come true, I'd save every day like a treasure, and then again I would spend them with you. But there never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do once you find them. I've looked around enough to know you're the one I want to go.